गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द फ्लेमिंग्स राइट हैंड रूल एंड फ्लेमिंग राइट हैंड रूल टू फाइंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंड्यूस करेंट. सो स्टूडेंट, ऑलरेडी इन प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैव एक्सप्लेन टू यू दैट इंड्यूस करेंट विच इज प्रोड्यूस इन टू द क्वाइल ड्यू टू द चेंज इन द मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स. So if magnetic flux changes either due to the relative motion between the bar magnet and the coil or due to the change in the current into the primary coil, a magnetic field lines which is passes through the coil which is either increases or decreases. So in all cases, if magnetic flux link with the coil change, then there will be generation of induced current. And student, induced current produce into the coil, either coil is rotating in the magnetic field. If the coil is rotating in a magnetic field, so there also be change in what? Magnetic flux, because magnetic field lines continuously changes by angle phi is equal to BA cos theta. If the coil is rotating, so angle between the area vector and the magnetic field, that is what? Changes. So magnetic induced current produced into the coil either by rotating the coil in the magnetic field or by changing the magnetic field into the coil. So first priority is given to that induced current is produced into the coil due to the rotating of the coil in the magnetic field. So student, when the motion of the coil is perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field, in that case the induced current which is produced into the coil, which is maximum, and in that case when the motion of the coil is at right angle to the direction of the magnetic field, the current which is produced into the coil, that is known as what? Induced current. And this induced current is what? Maximum. So to find the direction of induced current into the coil, we use a rule. That rule is known as Fleming's right hand rule. So Fleming's right hand rule can be used to find the direction of induced current. So Fleming right hand rule can be used to find the direction of induced current, and this Fleming right hand rule can be stated as, student, if we stretch our right hand first three finger, which are mutually perpendicular to each other, if we stretch our first three finger of right hand, which are mutually perpendicular to each other, so student, four finger point the direction of the magnetic field, thumb will give the direction of the motion of the conductor, means motion of the coil, then central finger which give the direction of the induced current. Once again, listen carefully. To find the direction of the induced current, we can use Fleming right hand rule, and Fleming right hand rule can be stated as if we stretch our right hand first three finger, which are mutually perpendicular to each other, then four finger point the direction of the magnetic field, thumb will give the direction of the motion of the conductor, so central finger which give the direction of induced current, and this induced current is maximum when direction of motion of the coil is perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. So student, Fleming right hand rule can be used to find the direction of the magnetic field due to the motion of the coil inside the magnetic field. And student, now I am going to solve some NCERT exercise question क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, 2, 12, 13, 14, 15 विच इज बेस्ड ऑन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन विद दिस टॉपिक. सो लिसन केयरफुली एंड आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व द एक्सरसाइज एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन. एंड फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दिस, यस. सो एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग करेक्टली डिस्क्राइब द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड नियर ए लॉन्ग स्ट्रेट वायर. नियर ए लॉन्ग स्ट्रेट वायर स्टूडेंट, यू नो दैट स्ट्रेट वायर डायरेक्ट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड पैटर्न लाइन्स व्हाट, कंसेंट्रिक सर्किल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइन्स, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड पैटर्न लाइन दैट इज व्हाट, कंसेंट्रिक सर्किल, दिस इज द आंसर. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन लिसन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग करेक्टली डिस्क्राइब द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड नियर ए लॉन्ग स्ट्रेट वायर. फर्स्ट आंसर, द फील्ड कंसिस्ट ऑफ स्ट्रेट लाइन परपेंडिकुलर टू द वायर, रॉन्ग. द फील्ड कंसिस्ट ऑफ स्ट्रेट लाइन पैरेलल टू द वायर, रॉन्ग. द फील्ड कंसिस्ट ऑफ रेडियल लाइन ओरिजिनेटिंग फ्रॉम द वायर, रॉन्ग. द फील्ड कंसिस्ट ऑफ कंसेंट्रिक सर्किल सेंटर्ड ऑन द वायर. सो ऑप्शन डी दैट इज व्हाट, करेक्ट. एंड ऑलरेडी यू नो दैट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू स्ट्रेट करेंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कंसेंट्रिक सर्किल. सो आंसर डी दैट इज व्हाट, करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, लिसन केयरफुली, द फिनोमेना ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन टू यू दैट द प्रोसेस ऑफ चार्जिंग ए बॉडी, रॉन्ग. द प्रोसेस ऑफ जनरेटिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू करेंट पासिंग थ्रू ए कॉइल, रॉन्ग. प्रोड्यूसिंग इंड्यूस्ड करेंट इन ए कॉइल ड्यू टू रिलेटिव मोशन बिटवीन ए मैग्नेट एंड द कॉइल, दिस इज द करेक्ट आंसर. सो सी आंसर दैट इज व्हाट, द फिनोमेना ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन producing induced current in a coil due to relative motion between a magnet and the coil. So option C that is what, correct. Already you know that induced current is what, produced due to the relative motion between the what, bar magnet and the coil. There will be change in the magnetic flux and there will be generation of induced current. So option 3 that is what, correct. Next question, that is question number 12. Question number 12, student, listen carefully. Name some devices in which electric motor are used. So I have already explained the construction working principle of the motor. So you have to give the some devices in which electric motors are used. So you know that electric fans, water pumps, coolers, refrigerator, mixer, washing machine, all these are based on what? All these are what? Devices on which electric motor are what? Used. And student, question number 12, question number 13, listen carefully. A coil of insulated copper is connected to a galvanometer. What would happen if a bar magnet is pushed into the coil, withdrawn from inside the coil, held stationary inside the coil? So student, question number 13, listen, question number 13, that is a coil which is connected with a what, galvanometer, and there will be a magnet or here north pole and south pole. So question is that a coil of insulated copper wire is connected to a galvanometer, clear? What would happen if a bar magnet is pushed into the coil? When bar magnet is pushed into the coil, so what will be happen? Magnetic field lines continuously what, increases. So magnetic, as the bar magnet moves into the coil, so number of magnetic field lines link with the coil continuously what, changes. And due to the change in the magnetic field lines continuously through a coil, so there will be a large change in the magnetic flux, and there will be what, deflection in the galvanometer takes place. So So momentarily deflection takes place into the galvanometer. It means what? When the north pole of bar magnet push towards the coil, there will be change in the magnetic field, and due to magnetic flux linked with the coil changes, an induced current produced into the coil and galvanometer show a momentarily deflection. Second question, second part. What would happen if a bar magnet withdrawn from inside the coil? It means what? Bar magnet is what? Moves away from the coil. Withdrawn means what? Taken away from the bar magnet. So when bar magnet is what? Bar magnet is moves away from the coil. So number of magnetic field lines linked with the coil, that is what? Decreases. So magnetic field lines linked with the coil, that is what? Decreases. As the bar magnet is what? Withdrawn from the coil. So motion of the bar magnet is takes place, a relative motion between the coil and the magnet is there. But as the bar magnet is withdrawn, so magnetic field lines linked with the coil, that is what? Decreases. So again there will be a magnetic flux linked with the coil changes. It is what? Decreases. So a momentarily deflection shown by the galvanometer, again there will be induced current will produce into the coil. Third point, what would happen if a bar magnet held stationary inside a coil? It means what? Bar magnet and coil both are stationary, so there will be no relative motion between the bar magnet and what? Coil. So there will be what? In that case, N and S, student, V, that is what? Zero. It means what? Third part. What would happen if a bar magnet held stationary inside the coil? So, if the bar magnet is stationary, it means what? Fixed magnetic field lines are passing through it. Fixed number of magnetic field lines is what is passing continuously. So, magnetic flux is still there. But fixed number of magnetic field lines are linked with the coil, there will be no change in the magnetic flux. So there will be no change in magnetic flux into the coil. So there will be no generation of induced current. So magnetic, so needle of galvanometer shows no deflection. So it means what? When bar magnet is held stationary, it means there will be no relative motion between the bar magnet and the coil, and there will be no generation of induced current into the coil, and galvanometer shows no deflection. Next question, student, question number 14. Listen carefully. Two circular coils A and B are placed close to each other. If the current in the coil A is changed, will some current be induced in coil B? Give region. So students, suppose the two coils, that is what? Already I have explained to you that suppose that a coil which is connected with what? Cell, and there will be a rheostat. Rheostat which change the resistance of a circuit. So there will be what? And another coil, that is what? Placed near it. There will be what? Galvanometer. And student, current is passing through this coil. So what will be what? Magnetic field lines, that is what? Continuously linked with the coil, that is what? Changes. So there will be what? Two circular coil which is taken in the form of solenoid. So if the current into the coil A, that is what? Change. If there will be current into the coil A is changed, it means what? Current produce a magnetic field. If current into the primary coil, that is what? Change. And magnetic field lines which crosses to the secondary coils which is connected with a galvanometer. So by varying the current into the coil A, there will be magnetic flux, magnetic field lines linked with the coil B continuously changes. And due to the change in the magnetic field lines, it means what? There will be change in the magnetic flux continuously takes place in coil B. So there will be a deflection in the galvanometer takes place. So induced current which is produced into the coil B by varying the current into the coil A, and this induced current is due to change in magnetic flux link with the coil B continuously changes, and due to the change in the magnetic flux link with the coil B continuously changes, induced current will produce into the coil. Next student, question number 15, listen carefully, already you know that. State the rule to determine the direction of first magnetic field produced around a straight conductor carrying a current. We have to state the law, rule, to determine the direction of magnetic field around a straight conductor carrying current. So already, which rule can be used to determine the direction of magnetic field lines due to straight current carrying conductor? That is right hand thumb rule. So right hand thumb rule can be used to determine the direction of magnetic field around a straight current carrying conductor. And what is this law? So right hand thumb rule can be used to determine the direction of magnetic field lines around a straight current carrying conductor. And this right hand thumb rule can be stated as, if we hold a straight current carrying conductor in our right hand in such a way that thumb will point the direction of the current, then curling finger around the wire so the magnetic field patterns lines which are in the form of concentric circle. If the current is flowing in upward direction, so magnetic field patterns lines is what? Anti-clockwise direction. And if the current flowing into the straight conductor is what? Downward direction. So magnetic field patterns lines is what? Clockwise direction. Second part, state the rule, determine the direction of first, second part, force experienced by current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field which is perpendicular to it. So force experienced by a current carrying straight conductor placed in a magnetic field which is perpendicular to it, state the rule to determine the direction of force. So direction of force in a straight current carrying conductor placed into the uniform magnetic field perpendicular to it, this rule, which is Fleming left hand rule. So Fleming left hand rule can be used to determine the direction of a force on a current carrying straight conductor placed into the uniform magnetic field. And the statement of the Fleming left hand rule is that if we stretch our first three fingers, which are usually perpendicular to each other, then four finger point the direction of the magnetic field, central finger give the direction of the what? Current. Then thumb will give the direction of motion of conductor, of direction of force on the conductor. If we stretch our left hand first three finger which are mutually perpendicular to each other, then four finger which give the direction of magnetic field, central finger give the direction of the current, then thumb will give the direction of the motion of the conductor or direction of force on a conductor. So Fleming left hand rule can be used to determine the direction of a force on a straight current carrying conductor which is placed into the uniform magnetic field. Last part, student, state the rule to determine the direction of current induced in a coil due to rotation in a magnetic field. I have recently, I have already explained this. State the rule to determine the direction of current induced in a coil due to its rotation in a magnetic field. So rotation of the coil in a magnetic field, there will be generation of what? Induced current. So which rule can be used to determine the current induced in a coil due to its rotation in a magnetic field? So rotation of the coil in a magnetic field which produces a induced current into the coil, this induced current determined by Fleming right hand rule. And Fleming right hand rule can be stated as, so Fleming right hand rule can be used to determine the direction of the induced current. And the statement of the Fleming right hand rule is that if we stretch our right hand first three finger which are usually perpendicular to each other, then four finger point the direction of what? Magnetic field. Thumb will give the direction of the motion of the conductor. Then central finger which give the direction of the induced current. Now student, I am going to revise some numericals which is based on current electricity. Two questions which are given here. This is the homework for you, and you will solve this question and send this answer tomorrow at up to 5 p.m. in WhatsApp group of 10th B. So this is the homework. You solve this question, question 1 and question 2, and solve it, and up to 5 p.m. tomorrow you can send your answer in WhatsApp group. Clear? So homework, that is what? Here 5 ohm, 20 ohm, 15 ohm, 10 ohm. Battery, that is what? 24 volt. In this circuit, you have to find total resistance of this circuit, and second, current through the circuit. And also here, in second question, find current through 3 ohm resistor. Here, battery voltage, that is what? Battery voltage 12 volt. Listen carefully. Battery voltage 12 volt. Here 4 ohm, 3 ohm, 6 ohm. Here I current, here I1 current, here I2 current. In this circuit, we have to find current through 3 ohm resistor. We have to find in this circuit current through 3 ohm resistor. Now student, now I am going to solve one numerical which is based on circuit. So you can easily find out how you will solve this problem. So question is that, now I am going to remove this circuit diagram. You take a screenshot of this question, and tomorrow at 5 p.m. you will send your answer through WhatsApp. Now student, a circuit diagram is given here. Student, and here 10 ohm, 20 ohm and 30 ohm resistance. 10 ohm, 20 ohm, 30 ohm, and cell potential difference 6 volt. Here current, that is what? I1. Here current I2, and here current I3. Total current, that is what? I. And student, we have to find current through each resistor. We have to find current through each resistor second, current through each resistor second, current supplied by the cell, total current supply by the cell, total current, and third student, that is equivalent resistance student. So we have to find current through each resistor. So student, see this diagram carefully. This 10 ohm, 20 ohm and 30 ohm resistances, their one point is connected to all these resistors. Their one end is connected to what? Positive potential of battery cell. and another end is connected to what? Negative terminal of the cell. So it means what? Potential at one end, first end of all resistor, that is what? Positive potential. And another end is connected to what? Negative potential. So potential difference in this circuit, potential difference across each resistor, that is what? Same. Because you know that in parallel combination, potential difference across each resistor, that is what? Same. So potential difference across 10 ohm, that is what? 6 volt. Potential difference across 20, 6 ohm. Potential difference across 30, that is what? 6 volt. So student, since all resistors here are connected in parallel, so potential difference across PD across each resistors remain same, that is 6 volt. It means what? Potential difference across 10 ohm, 6 volt, 20 ohm, 6 volt, 30 ohm, 6 volt. So potential difference, we know the across 10 ohm, 20 ohm, and resistance is also, you know that, so easily we can use the Ohm's law to find the current I1, I2, I3. Current through 10 ohm resistance, current I1 through 10 ohm resistance. So students, we know that I that is Ohm's law, I that is what? V by R1, V here R1 10 ohm, that is what? R1, R2 that is what? 22 ohm, and R3 we have taken, suppose that 30 ohm. So potential difference across each resistor, that is what? 6 volt. So here 6 by R1, R1 means what? 10 student. So that is what? 0.6 ampere current flowing through what? 10 ohm resistance. Similarly, current I2 through 20 ohm resistance formula, that is what? I2 potential difference, that is what? Same. Resistance change, R2, V that is what? 6. So student, that is what? 20. R2 that is what? 20, and that is what? 3 by 10, 2 into 10, 2 3 jar, that is what 0.3 ampere student. Similarly, current I3 across 30 ohm resistors, same formula, we use I3, that is what? V by R3, V that is what? 6, and resistance, that is what? This one, and a student, and 6 5 ja, 1 by 5 means what? 2 ampere, 0.2 ampere. So I1 comes out to be that 0.6 ampere, I2 comes out to 0.3 ampere, and I3 comes out to be that what? 0.2 ampere. And here total current, which is divided into I1, I2, I3. So total current, which is equal to the sum of current of I1, I2, I3. So total current, that is what? Total current in a circuit, total current through circuit, means this total current supplied by the cell, which is I equal to what? I1 plus I2 plus I3. So here I1 we have calculated 0.6, I2 calculated, that is what, 0.3, and I3 calculated 0.2. So 639211, that is what? Total current, that is what? I, that is what? 1.1 ampere, student. 639211, 1.111. And last, total resistance we have to find. And student, already you see there, see that these resistances which are connected in which manner? That is what? In parallel. So parallel combination of resistances, already you know the formula of parallel combination. You know that in parallel combination, here R1 10 ohm, R2 that is what, 20 ohm, and R3 that is what, 30 ohm, are connected in parallel, so formula you know that in parallel combination, R1 by R equal to what, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, and in series combination R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus, but in parallel combination 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, and we have to find equivalent resistance. So R equivalent means total resistance. R1 that is what, 10, R2 that is what, 20, and R3 that is what, 30, and student LCM that is what, 60, that is what, 6, 3, that is what, 2. So 1 by R equivalent, student, 60 by 639211. By 60, reciprocal of it, R reciprocal, that is what, 60 by 11. So divide it, 11 5 jar 55, that is 55 5, 11 4 jar 44, 6, and 60, 11 5 jar. So it comes out to be that here 5, so it can be written as 5.5 ohm. So R equivalent resistance of circuit comes out to be that 5.5 ohm, and this is the answer for this question. And student, remember that tomorrow at up to 5 p.m. you will send the answer of the given homework. Thank you.